The meaning of Christmas. Christmas is an annual festival commemorating the birth of Jesus Christ, observed primarily on December 25 as a religious and cultural celebration by billions of people around the world. A feast central to the Christian liturgical year, it is preceded by the season of Advent or the Nativity Fast and initiates the season of Christmastide, which historically in the West lasts 12 days and culminates on Twelfth Night. Christmas Day is a public holiday in many countries, is celebrated religiously by a majority of Christians, as well as culturally by many non-Christians, and forms an integral part of the holiday season organized around it. Many of us are so excited during Christmas because we received a lot of gifts from our parents and relatives. Singing Christmas carols, fireworks and yummy foods. But do we know the real meaning of Christmas and why we celebrate it? Today we are going to learn why we celebrate Christmas. The traditional Christmas narrative, the Nativity of Jesus, delineated in the New Testament says that Jesus was born in Bethlehem, in accordance with messianic prophecies. When Joseph and Mary arrived in the city, the inn had no room and so they were offered a stable where the Christ child was soon born, with angels proclaiming this news to shepherds who then spread the word. Although the month and date of Jesus' birth are unknown, the Church in the early 4th century fixed the date as December 25. This corresponds to the date of the winter solstice on the Roman calendar. It is exactly 9 months after Annunciation on March 25, also the date of the spring equinox. Most Christians celebrate on December 25 in the Gregorian calendar, which has been adopted almost universally in the civil calendars used in countries throughout the world. However, some Eastern Christian churches celebrate Christmas on December 25 of the older Julian calendar, which currently corresponds to January 7 in the Gregorian calendar. For Christians, believing that God came into the world in the form of man to atone for the sins of humanity, rather than knowing Jesus' exact birth date, is considered to be the primary purpose in celebrating Christmas. The celebratory customs associated in various countries with Christmas have a mix of pre-Christian, Christian, and secular themes and origins. Popular modern customs of the holiday include gift-giving, completing an Advent calendar or Advent wreath, Christmas music and caroling, viewing a nativity play, an exchange of Christmas cards, church services, a special meal, and the display of various Christmas decorations, including Christmas trees, Christmas lights, nativity scenes, garlands, wreaths, mistletoe, and holly. In addition, several closely related and often interchangeable figures, known as Santa Claus, Father Christmas, Saint Nicholas, and Christkind, are associated with bringing gifts to children during the Christmas season and have their own body of traditions and lore. Because gift-giving and many other aspects of the Christmas festival involve heightened economic activity, the holiday has become a significant event and a key sales period for retailers and businesses. The economic impact of Christmas has grown steadily over the past few centuries in many regions of the world. The Gospels of Luke and Matthew describe Jesus as being born in Bethlehem to the Virgin Mary. In Luke, Joseph and Mary travel from Nazareth to Bethlehem for the census, and Jesus is born there and laid in a manger. Angels proclaimed him a savior for all people, and shepherds came to adore him. Matthew adds that the Magi follow a star to Bethlehem to bring gifts to Jesus, born the King of the Jews. King Herod orders the massacre of all the boys less than 2 years old in Bethlehem, but the family flees to Egypt and later returns to Nazareth. The nativity sequences included in the Gospels of Matthew and Luke prompted early Christian writers to suggest various dates for the anniversary. Although no date is indicated in the Gospels, early Christians connected Jesus to the Son through the use of such phrases as Son of Righteousness. The Romans marked the winter solstice on December 25. The first recorded Christmas celebration was in Rome on December 25, AD 336. In the 3rd century, the date of the Nativity was the subject of great interest. Around AD 200, Clement of Alexandria. In the early Middle Ages, Christmas Day was overshadowed by Epiphany, which in Western Christianity focused on the visit of the Magi. The biblical Magi, also referred to as the three wise men or three kings, also the three Magi, were distinguished foreigners in the Gospel of Matthew and Christian tradition. They are said to have visited Jesus after his birth, bearing gifts of gold, frankincense and myrrh. They are regular figures in traditional accounts of the nativity celebrations of Christmas and are an important part of Christian tradition. But the medieval calendar was dominated by Christmas-related holidays. The 40 days before Christmas became the 40 days of Saint Martin, which began on November 11, the feast of Saint Martin of Tours, now known as Advent. In Italy, former Saturnalian traditions were attached to Advent. Around the 12th century, these traditions transferred again to the 12 days of Christmas, December 25 to January 5, a time that appears in the liturgical calendars as Christmastide or 12 holy days. The prominence of Christmas Day increased gradually after Charlemagne was crowned emperor on Christmas Day in 800. King Edmund the Martyr was anointed on Christmas in 855 and King William I of England was crowned on Christmas Day 1066. By the High Middle Ages, the holiday had become so prominent that chroniclers routinely noted where various magnates celebrated Christmas. King Richard II of England hosted a Christmas feast in 1377 at which 28 oxen and 300 sheep were eaten. The Yule boar was a common feature of medieval Christmas feasts. Caroling also became popular, and was originally performed by a group of dancers who sang. The group was composed of a lead singer and a ring of dancers that provided the chorus. Various writers of the time condemned caroling as lewd, indicating that the unruly traditions of Saturnalia and Yule may have continued in this form. Misruled drunkenness, promiscuity, gambling, was also an important aspect of the festival. In England, gifts were exchanged on New Year's Day. Various factors contributed to the selection of December 25th as a date of celebration. It was the date of the winter solstice on the Roman calendar and it was 9 months after March 25th, the date of the vernal equinox and a date linked to the conception of Jesus, celebrated as the Feast of the Annunciation. Christmas played a role in the Arian controversy of the 4th century. After this controversy ran its course, the prominence of the holiday declined for a few centuries. The feast regained prominence after 800 when Charlemagne was crowned emperor on Christmas Day. In Puritan England, Christmas was banned as it was associated with drunkenness and other misbehavior. It was restored as a legal holiday in England in 1660, but remained disreputable in the minds of many people. In the early 19th century, Christmas festivities and services became widespread with the rise of the Oxford movement in the Church of England that emphasized the centrality of Christmas in Christianity and charity to the poor. Christmas does not appear on the lists of festivals given by the early Christian writers Irenaeus and Tertullian. Origen and Arnobius fault the pagans for celebrating birthdays, which suggests that Christmas was not celebrated in their time. Arnobius wrote after AD 297. The chronograph of 354 records that a Christmas celebration took place in Rome in 336, 8 days before the calends of January. In the East, the birth of Jesus was celebrated in connection with the Epiphany on January 6. This holiday was not primarily about the Nativity, but rather the baptism of Jesus. Christmas was promoted in the East as part of the revival of Orthodox Christianity that followed the death of the pro-Arian Emperor Valens at the Battle of Adrianople in 378. The feast was introduced in Constantinople in 379, in Antioch by John Chrysostom towards the end of the 4th century, probably in 388, and in Alexandria in the following century. December 25th was the date of the winter solstice in the Roman calendar. A late 4th century sermon by Saint Augustine explains why this was a fitting day to celebrate Christ's nativity. Hence it is that he was born on the day which is the shortest in our earthly reckoning and from which subsequent days begin to increase in length. He, therefore, who bent low and lifted us up chose the shortest day, yet the one when light begins to increase. Linking Jesus to the sun was supported by various biblical passages. Jesus was considered to be the Son of Righteousness prophesied by Malachi, "Unto you shall the Son of Righteousness arise, and healing is in his wings." Such solar symbolism could support more than one date of birth. An anonymous work known as De Pascha Computus, 243, linked the idea that creation began at the spring equinox, on March 25, with the conception or birth. The word Nascor can mean either, of Jesus on March 28, the day of the creation of the sun in the Genesis account. One translation reads, "O the splendid and divine providence of the Lord, that on that day, the very day, on which the sun was made, March 28, a Wednesday, Christ should be born." In the 17th century, Isaac Newton, who, coincidentally, was born on December 25, argued that the date of Christmas may have been selected to correspond with the solstice. For the Christian celebration of Christmas, the viewing of the Nativity play is one of the oldest Christmastime traditions, with the first reenactment of the Nativity of Jesus taking place in AD 1223. In that year, Francis of Assisi assembled a Nativity scene outside of his church in Italy and children sung Christmas carols celebrating the birth of Jesus. Each year, this grew larger and people traveled from afar to see Francis' depiction of the Nativity of Jesus that came to feature drama and music. Nativity plays eventually spread throughout all of Europe, where they remain popular. Christmas Eve and Christmas Day church services often came to feature Nativity plays, as did schools and theaters. The earliest extant specifically Christmas hymns appear in 4th century Rome. Latin hymns such as Veni Redemptor Gentium, written by Ambrose, Archbishop of Milan, were austere statements of the theological doctrine of the Incarnation in opposition to Arianism. Cordatus ex parentis, of the Father's love begotten, by the Spanish poet Prudentius is still sung in some churches today. In the 9th and 10th centuries, the Christmas sequence or prose was introduced in North European monasteries, developing under Bernard of Clairvaux into a sequence of rhymed stanzas. In the 12th century, the Parisian monk Adam of St. Victor began to derive music from popular songs, introducing something closer to the traditional Christmas carol. The songs now known specifically as carols were originally communal folk songs sung during celebrations such as Harvesttide as well as Christmas. It was only later that carols began to be sung in church. Traditionally, carols have often been based on medieval chord patterns, and it is this that gives them their uniquely characteristic musical sound. Some carols like Person and Ho Die, Good King Wenceslas, and the Holly and the Ivy can be traced directly back to the Middle Ages. They are among the oldest musical compositions still regularly sung. Adeste Fidelis, O Come All Ye Faithful, appears in its current form in the mid-18th century, although the words may have originated in the 13th century.